Welcome to this session on language assessment. I am Kirti Kapoor, Professor of English from NCERT. Today we are going to talk about assessment, that too in a language classroom. Assessment at the primary stage needs to focus on fluency. Okay, accuracy and correctness can come later. After the primary stage, we may balance correctness and fluency and pay attention to both. So, therefore, we need to begin with the fluency so that children start becoming comfortable with the new language that they are learning. Fine? We want to know the language abilities acquired by the child through assessment. So, therefore, three things I am highlighting over here. One is at the initial stages, primary stage, even till the upper primary stage also we can say that focus should be on fluency. Whether the children are making meaning out of the language that they are learning or not, are they becoming comfortable with the language, and then accuracy and correctness can follow with practice at a later stage. And we have to now assess their skills, whether they are acquiring the skills of language learning or not. The use of correct words with correct grammar and correct pronunciation or correctness in writing is termed as using pure and accurate language, and this comes at a very later stage. We have to begin learning, and if we at the beginning only we start looking at correct grammar, correct words, correctness of everything, then somewhere the child becomes conscious. They become very underconfident that they are not able to use the language that the teacher wants us to use. Therefore, give them some flexibility. This is a process of learning. On the other hand, the ability that enables the child to speak, read and write with ease and express herself is called fluency. Now, you must have understood the difference between accuracy and fluency. So, we begin with fluency and gradually take the learner towards accuracy and correctness, and all these will help us in our assessment processes. While assessing children's language, the emphasis should be more on meaning and context rather than on grammatical errors. You see, errors can be corrected, but language learning is basically meaning making. Are the children able to create meaning, get meaning, are able to write from their context? So, this is the process that we want to assess. Before starting, the assessor has to consider if the learners have been provided a variety of repeated opportunities to acquire these abilities. You see, we cannot assess the learners straight away. Before we start assessing, we have to provide them various opportunities. For example, if it's reading, you have to give them enough opportunities to read different types of texts. Then only we are able to assess them. Unless they have had such opportunities, assessment is pointless. If we do assessment using activities, it is not necessary to have a separate activity for each and every skills. Remember, we teach language in an integrated manner. When we are speaking, somebody is listening, isn't it? Also, when we read, that helps us in writing. Therefore, all these skills develop in an integrated manner. We can take an activity which assesses three or more or four abilities. Therefore, you see, if we are giving them dictation, children are listening, children are writing, we are assessing their listening ability, we are assessing their vocabulary, okay? So, we are assessing children's abilities, children's skills in an integrated manner, because language happens in an integrated manner. Children should be able to describe a picture. I am taking an example. They should be able to express themselves freely, give their views on what they have heard or they have seen. These could be conversations, lectures or discussions. So, therefore, if they are looking at a picture, let them explain the way they want. probably in their context, that particular picture, that particular object has a different name. Let them use it. This is multilingualism. And there should be conversations, lectures, discussions. So you can bring in so many things into the classroom as per the level of the learners. Children should listen to each other. Children should listen to poems. Children should listen to some video scripts, etc. So a variety, a range of activities should be provided to the learners, and then only we can assess them. Then they should be able to use correct words and respond in complete sentences to information seeking questions. They should be able to talk about known things, people and events. The basic issue here is reading with understanding. Even if it is individual words and sentences, it is always better to embed all reading in a context, because context creates meaning. We may initially assess the ability to recognize known words and be able to read words with comprehension. To begin with, we are talking about a reading now. If they can recognize words, if they can read words with comprehension, then we can assess the learners that they can do this much, and now we can provide them the next level of activity, that is, we can ask them to read complete sentences. Subsequently, a child should be able to read words and sentences written with pictures, stories, and be able to tell the main points of the material read, the story or the skit that they have read. This means comprehension. This means they are getting the meaning out of reading. He or she should be able to interpret words, read according to the context. During the assessment of writing, try and see if learners are able to write letters of the alphabet and simple words. So, we have finished discussing the reading. Now, we are going to talk about writing. For writing, to begin with, at the beginning stages, children should be able to write letters of the alphabet, simple words, and it should be legible. It should be easily readable. Later on, they can be assessed on writing letters or words without seeing. Earlier, they are writing, looking at the text from their textbook or from the blackboard, they are able to write. But later on, the next step is they should be able to write without seeing. So, we are increasing the level of assessment for learners. Subsequently, they could be assessed on writing one word or one sentence answers to questions that are spoken out to them or read by them. So, gradually we are increasing the level of the writing assessment. The next stage would be they are able to write descriptions in two or three sentences and write spoken unfamiliar words. So, therefore, now they are simultaneously reading some words, and when the teacher speaks those words, they are able to write without looking at the text. So, therefore, speaking has increased. We can assess their speaking, that when a particular picture is shown to them, they speak about it, they are able to read about it, and when the teacher speaks, they listen very carefully and they are able to understand. And when it comes to writing, they are able to write two or three words or two or three sentences without looking at any text. So, therefore, you know, they are developing their skills, their abilities in an integrated manner in conjunction with each other. But if we are assessing writing, we will focus on assessing, and we can say that children are able to now write two or three sentences on their own. In this, the learner should be able to make a picture of things or events according to, now we are talking about expression, that how expression can be assessed for learners. We talked about reading, we talked about writing, and now we are talking about expression. In this, the learner should be able to make a picture of things or events according to what she has seen. So, expressing herself through drawings. So, art is playing a role over here. Subsequently, he or she should be expected to make pictures of his own, on her own, freely, and enact a poem or a story or an event. So, expressing, Now, expressing can be through spoken, through written expression. Then you can give them, you can ask them, draw pictures from the real world situations. Or you have narrated a poem. It is about a bird, it is about a tree. Ask them to draw it. A story or an event, or ask them to talk about it. Whatever they did yesterday, they can talk about it. So they are developing expression not only in writing but also in the spoken form. And from where are we getting the context? From the child's context. He or she could be assessed on making things with clay or any other material. We may also like to assess them on creating or extending stories. You have narrated a story. You have come to a particular conclusion. Now you can ask the children, do you want to extend the story? Do you want to add something to it? Do you have another story to tell us about birds, about your pets? Things like that. So this is how you help learners develop their expression, and you assess them whether they are able to do this or not. Then methods of assessment in language learning. I have given you a background that how assessment can be done of in various situations. And assessment is not formal. Assessment is informal. How we move from one sentence to one paragraph, helping learners. Simultaneously, we are assessing them. So some methods we are going to discuss now. Language assessment is mostly based on a written or on an oral exam. That is what we have seen around us. The question paper is generally based on the textbook or on memory rather than on capability or understanding of the language. In the new method of assessment, oral expression, imagination, observation, etc. have to be included. We cannot do only oral or written tests. So therefore, expression is important. That means we should give opportunity to the child to speak, because we have been giving lot of opportunities in the classroom to learners to speak about various things, and we were assessing them all along. Assessment for learning was happening. But now, when we are assessing them, we should assess them on oral expression, their imagination, their observation, along with written and oral exam. Oral tests can be both formal and informal. Talking to children on different topics, asking questions, organizing group discussions, having them act or mime can be a part of the teaching learning process. And simultaneously, you are assessing them. Like if you are taking drama, role play, then acting, then miming, then speaking the dialogues, and then showing it with expressions and voice modulation, it is part of the oral assessment that child is able to understand the context and able to express herself. During these, the language abilities can be assessed. Following can be the formal activities that can be organized for oral test. Question answer session, you can do question answer session. In this, children are taken through a question answer session. The initial questions should require only such answers that children can provide initially. Maybe they are basic question, comprehension questions, maybe they are true and false, maybe they are just fill in the blanks. So it should be as per the understanding of the children. These questions could be around their daily life, their experiences, their interests, and their needs. Because we are focusing right now on the oral, that is the spoken assessment. So when we are trying to assess for the oral expression of the child, you can ask them to talk about their experiences, when they play with the ball, how do they enjoy it, their interests, what do they like to do, what do they like to eat, what do they want, all of that. So this will help you assess whether they have been able to develop that expression or not. In this activity, the teacher as the assessor must give children plenty of opportunity to articulate their ideas. Of course, the teacher must have the capability and art of making good questions. You should design questions which should not be very difficult, which should immediately relate to the child's context. This question answer session can assess the vocabulary, pronunciation, and sentence formation ability of the children. So simultaneously, we are assessing so many things: spoken ability, vocabulary, pronunciation, sentence formation. And as per, we can then design our next lesson or next activity depending on this assessment. Now we are talking about storytelling. Okay, the child telling a story that he or she has read or heard in his or her own words can be an important form of assessment. The story could also be something that he or she has created herself. So here we are focusing only on the imagination, creativity, oral expression of the child. The moment they develop confidence in this, you will find that they are able to talk about various topics that feature in the textbook, because you have been able to develop the confidence of the child. We should keep in mind this objective of assessing and take into account the expression, the presentation, and the remembering of the order of events as indicators in assessment. So for storytelling, what are the indicators? Presentation, expression, remembering the events. These are some of the indicators. So while assessing, you have to design, you have to keep in mind the indicators. So these indicators will help you assess the child in a holistic manner. While assessing the ability to read aloud, now we are talking about reading aloud, the pronunciation and intonation according to the meaning, including the emphasis on certain words to clarify the meaning, can also be assessed. We never read any text in a flat manner. We take care of our pronunciation, we take care of our stress, where we lay more stress, where we lay less stress, that is intonation, our tone, everything has to be assessed. Then only we develop reading aloud, which is a part of speaking activity. Now, in this test, texts expressing different kinds of emotions, pieces of big and small conversations, portions of a play, or the portion of a textbook can be given as texts to be read aloud. You don't have to give something that is difficult for the learners. Give them a piece, which can be a small anecdote, which can be a small poem, which can be a portion from the textbook, and then ask the child to read aloud. And here you will assess their, how they pronounce it, how they read it properly with expression. If a child is not able to pronounce properly and not able to use appropriate expression to bring out the question mark or exclamation mark, even then she should not be interrupted. Let the child read, because the moment you interrupt the child, the confidence level will go down. Because in speaking, when there is an explanation in a particular sentence, when there is question mark in a particular sentence, of course grammatical categories tell us, for a question mark we say, what are you doing? But for explanation we have to raise our tone. What are you doing? Therefore I am giving you an exclamation mark kind of a thing over here. If you interrupt the children, this would produce fear and disinterest in the learners, then they will stop learning. So therefore you have to be very, very careful when you are assessing the learners. Now, describing what has been seen, heard or read, that is also spoken. In assessing language ability, description is a very important aspect. In the beginning of the primary classes, the learner can be shown an object, a picture or some action in familiar context and asked to describe it. Therefore, they develop confidence to speak. Show them the familiar things which you have already shown. Maybe you have already talked about apple, aeroplane, or you have already talked about different kinds of animals, different kinds of fruits, or you have already discussed parts of tree. Then give them, show them that. They already know that. Therefore, they will be able to speak and you can assess them on their speaking ability. Then in the initial stages, the description can start with just one sentence. This is a cow, this is a dog, that's it. And then gradually as they move on to higher classes, from primary to upper primary, the description can become comprehensive, picture can become comprehensive, and accordingly children can speak about it. Or you can show them some advertisements, important advertisement that we show, that we see around us, like Swachh Bharat. Show them that particular advertisement and have a discussion in the classroom. Why should we keep our surroundings clean? All of them can become part of our classroom discourse. It is up to you to guide students for correct pronunciation and for speaking correctly. Now we come to observation. When you are teaching to a class, you are observing the responses of learners informally. There should be a record of these observations. This record would help in assessing the felicity in language and ability of free expression. Instead of giving marks or grades in the assessment, we can use 3 to 5 point scale. The table can be of the following form, like description 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, word knowledge, fluency, syntax, expression. In this table, 5 is excellent and performance and 3 is average. So, therefore, you can have scaling for your record. You are not showing it to the child. So, you must maintain record of every child because you need reference. Then, 2 and anything below indicates that there is a need to give the child more opportunities to acquire the ability. Now we come to written text. In this kind of test, it is very important to concentrate on the question paper. The question paper should be such that it is able to assess the following: reading comprehension, imagination and creativity, because you are going to assess the learners through reading, through written paper. And reading comprehension is part of that question paper. Then free expression, ability to argue and to write precisely, ability to compare, ability to understand differences, etc. Then the question paper must test abilities rather than memory. It should test the skills. It should be able to add to the critical reference ability of the learner, reasoning ability of the learner. Questions must give the learner opportunity to express her experiences. So, questions should not be based on rote memory. They should be based on child's own experiences. There must be questions that help her to develop ability to analyze. The emphasis should be on learners using their own words and not to be expected to reproduce exactly the language of the textbook. So, we have come to the end of this session. Thank you for listening to this session.